basically a present for my nephews. Something silly, like a fake Santa. And he'll be holding a puppy, probably. So, fixing those fingers now. Hey guys. Hey, hey. Yep. I will. Open widget, what is this? YouTube is not receiving a video to mainstream small stream. Huh. YouTube is complaining. Are you guys seeing this well? Or not so well. Yes, okay, cool. Thanks, Michael. Ma friendo. Then what is YouTube complaining about? Cool, cool, cool. Thanks, guys. So yeah, I just made a quick hand, actually two of them. And there will be a little puppy here, I think. If I don't put a doggo, I don't know who else will. Merry Christmas to you, Nicholas. Yeah, yeah, we'll definitely do like a Q&A for this one, what you're asking. I just don't wanna drop it super casual. Not that it's not casual, but I wanna spend the proper dedicated time for it, because otherwise I'm not even sure. Yeah, I don't want to overlook basically the topic, because it's a little bit longer and not many digital artists agree with me, which is fine. Yeah. Yeah, we'll talk about it. It's a long topic basically. What pose you can apply, and which one is more fine than another, and all that. So guys, I made those from Z-Sphere. As you can see, I'm every time starting differently, just because it's more whatever, it's more fun. Usually you do more wrinkles where you have compression, of course, and towards the bone structure there's pressure coming from here, right? So the Rinko will fade off. At least that's what I've observed. Again, no rules. But it looks alright when you do it. Oops, this way. What else? How are you guys doing? Yeah, Michael. Basically, it was a Kinder Egg, and then from all these dog patrol shit, I got the Dalmatian, which was super cool. And it's not like I have, you know, bought them all. It was just once. But they knew I have a Dalmatian. You, yay. Let's do those fingers a little bit longer there because of the cloth. We don't want them to look exactly like fingers, because there's cloth, and then the usually the cloth finishes there, especially if you're wearing bigger glove, this is what you get. And I want this guy to look like he wants to be Santa, but you know, he is, everything is oversized, so there's no reference for his clothing. Under hands and cloth, just by observing, or there's a precise rules. Honestly, I drew a lot of draperies, and I always loved wrinkles and like folds, but there is always a, there's a logic behind those things. And when Marvelous came, I thought, you know, we are all doomed, like we maybe think with AI right now, that at some point no one will care. But actually, if you can do it and you're faster and it works, I would say we can stay this way. Thanks, man. How long does it take me? Well, the stream took 53 minutes, but I didn't work only on the hands. So, I don't know. Yeah, Michael, I agree with you. So yeah, Nicholas, you can, I mean, this will be recorded at some point. I think it is already. So basically you can watch the entire thing, but I've started from this crap. Look at this. Ta-da, that's what we had, and it was with adaptive skin, right? These are the Z-spheres. Pa 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 pa. So that's what we got, and then from here, I just basically, you need to look at your proportions, but of course with Z-spheres is bullshit, like you can't do it. And from here, I knew I wanna go for the hand and for the wrinkles, for the gloves, and where the puppy will be, because I've been walking in the park, and I was like, how is he going to hold this dude, right? So wait, let me change the music. Oof. Let's listen to some Last of Us, guys. As I'm a huge fan of the series, the game basically, the series not yet. Let's see. Yeah, Michael, of course. There's always, like, for example, if your wrinkles here follow this, like, I don't have the exact reference, but I'm sure that the wrinkles will fall this way. Oops. Like this way, and then if there's a pinching, you're gonna get this thing, right? Oops. And then where it bulges is here. So, and then of course in the where here the meaty part is, you're gonna get this one softened and maybe a little bit of crease. And then this will bulge. There we go. And then this one may get lost a little bit. Here there will be more, but of course, because you have already the leading one, you're gonna get another one that is less obvious. And then maybe you will get a few going this way. But we need to fix the forms first. A little bit. So there's always a logic, and when you see it like this, it's obvious that here we're gonna have to enhance a few and get a few like deeper ones. It's just, in a way, at some point I always feel that really made my work on hands 10 times faster and easier. Now can I choose an edge? Yeah, absolutely. You can do like a mesh basically, and reuse it every time. I have this. But now that I was streaming, I wanted to just kind of have something a little bit more, I don't know, freestyle and challenging in a way. Because it kind of sucks when everyone watches to start a hand. Could be tricky. So if I have started with a pre-made one, better for me, easier. But if I make this work, and we're, I think, on our way to do that, you always need to be careful not to break fingers and to look from everywhere. So we are on our way to do that, and if we succeed, I think watching the stream from the beginning will make more sense. Otherwise, what? Not much really interesting. But this looks like a glove now. I can take it. Otherwise, yes, if you're in production, especially, etc., I have a seriously worked up topology that follows knuckles and tendons, and I think it's pretty awesome because you can, in a way, you have the, if you doubt anything, the anatomy is within the mesh, if that makes sense. You want to check where the tendons they go because they don't follow knuckles, not knuckles, they don't follow the bone structure. So it's a reminder, you know, this is the bones, they go this way, but the tendons, they go like even this way, right? And then here, that's how tendons are. So it's cool to be able to have a reminder, because anatomy is like, there's always a question mark what's going on, especially when you move a few things. One love, Nazarene, if I read this correct. One love is good, right? I think so. So let's fix a little more there, and I don't know, as a sketch, it's kind of doing like telling the story, so we can move to the next thing. And since I'm not making anything serious, and I need to print it, relatively soon. Yeah, we can't refine anything too much, unfortunately. But it's fun, I've never streamed before and you guys keep me company. So, thanks for joining. Those deep creases I absolutely hate, and guys, if you try to fix them, just use the move brush from the side and then some clay and that will fix it, because otherwise if you start just adding clay there, you will end up with lots of intersections, so not great. Man, I already am kinda having the plan. I'm traveling today out of town, so that's your plan there. Let's open this finger a little more. What about you? What are the plans there? What are you guys doing? I see Michael posting lots of pictures of his home. So he's staying home. Taking a break, Michael, leave that stream. Not that I'm not enjoying your lovely company, but take a proper break. I started The Witcher 3 again yesterday and I think it's just a masterpiece. Cool, Nicholas, sometimes that's what we need, right? Just chill and stay at home. I personally enjoy it quite a lot. Cool. I think, I know, man, I'm the same. I buy games because I can. Thank you, Andre. Thank you, mate. Let me save, huh? Trying to get in Christmas mood. You're a little late. I think you had to have been already. But better later than never, right? So what do I know? Cool, guys, so I changed, oof, ugly. So yeah, we had this shit and then I changed. So we started here, then I had this, then I got into this guy because I saw this dude, right? and he was, I don't know, looking quite interesting. That's a Aubrey Beardsley, whatever. Beardsley, it's like he's wearing a beard. So yeah, quite cool face. So I wanted someone quite lean and, you know, interesting nose and all that. So a little more interesting face there. So here, and I'll leave it there for now. And then, one second, we can do, no, yeah, like this, and there we go. Let's fix the arms. New Year more than Christmas. Okay, cool. Then you're fine. Kameha Master. Where are you from, man? Where is that country? Hey CG Ford, Merry Christmas, buddy, and yeah, thanks so much to you and your family as well. Boom, there we go, let's fix that arm. We, on the other hand, we celebrate Christmas big time, guys. We are like, it's super, it's basically very family oriented. And then New Year's Eve, you just need to be as drunk and as wild as possible. And you most likely are with your friends and not your family. But Christmas is all about family. Ah, dude. Grigor Zvyazda. Yes, I know him, of course. He is, yeah, I think he should have reference though, which by all means, that doesn't mean anything. He is amazing. So yeah, totally makes sense what you said. His drapery work is fantastic. Boom. Andre George, hello man, happy holidays to you too. Oh, I see, Russia. No, you can say whatever you want. I think you guys are big on Christmas. No, you are, you know, proper Christian similar to Bulgaria, right? So, where I'm from. Maybe you can tell by my English. Oof, what are we listening? Last Samurai. This is so good. Guys, I wish I had a coffee right now. At some point I need to go to get the coffee. But we're good for now. There we go, we are getting somewhere. Gladiator. No, it's... I absolutely love Gladiator too. But Last Samurai is also amazing. Basically everything Hans Zimmer like. Yeah, that's gonna be horrible. Gladiator 2, like one of the movies where that you don't need to touch. So let's see, I guess the Rinker will go this way and then it will be softer. Merry Christmas, Morgan. So here, guys, if we keep the hand this way, I think it will be broken. But if we do this and we rotate it this way, I think we're fine. Let's add a little bit of... I always like getting that pinky a little bit to the side because it always does that. There we go. Much more natural. And usually it goes slightly higher than the rest. And then it gets this. Cool. Yeah, I don't know about Gladiator really, guys. It's just a phenomenal movie. And now a second part, like really, do we need it? Leave it where it was, Ridley. We'll see. All right, we have our hands, we have our face, and now I think we need to add a little bit of face symmetry to this, because it's just too symmetrical. It will never be this way. Do you guys prefer transpose, or you prefer, or you prefer the new, not so new gizmo? Let me start a discussion. Starting discussion, I can check how much is the delay. Okay. I still don't know how to measure things with the transpose. How do you do that? I've seen people measuring, but yeah, unsure exactly how it's done. When I move stuff like that, I'm using this one. The gizmo, yeah, okay. I like the transpose quite a lot. I guess I'm old school, although I'm not so. Yeah, of course. Of course, I do think about those things. Quite a lot, actually. Because, yeah, they're very important. And also, I think when you sculpt, you just need to keep observing things from different angles. Like, really observe from different angles. I mean, sculpture is really much, it needs to be rich and different, and to have the rhythm from all angles, not just look fine from one. And that's what makes it a lot more interesting than, I mean, not to take anything away from drawing, but we need to take care of all these angles. Oh, there's your interstellar, which is no need to say. I am very excited for the Oppenheimer because I love not only Christopher Nolan but Cillian Murphy. I think he's an amazing actor. So yeah, quite excited. Let's see that. For sure. Have to look at some reference for this hat because it's actually quite complicated, but for now we are still just, I don't know, sketching. Everything is always sketch until you actually get worried about refining it, then it doesn't feel like a sketch anymore, if you know what I mean. And I think refinement is a lot more tricky, because you don't want to lose what's fresh in your sketch, but you need to be bold not to be enslaved in the form that is already there. But because sometimes it will be great and you should preserve it, but sometimes it will need definitely to step in and to break, you know, the things that they're not so good. But that process of what's good, what's not, and that constant judgment is basically draining, and it's a lot more tricky than just sketching. Because sketching in the beginning, no expectations, looks like simple sketch, whatever. No one cares. If you start refining, you find yourself a little bit of a bit more troubled. And after a few hours, when you compare old and new, you don't want to end up like you have lost, like you have ruined it, you know? Because it's, I think that's the worst feeling, actually, if you ask me. What's the worst feeling? I think it's, I mean, if we're talking about work, right? I think that's looking at your work, having put the time, and actually going backwards. I think it absolutely sucks. So as you see here, those folds are totally made up, but they kind of feel, I guess, I would say, okay-ish, right? There is something nice with them, because they're very asymmetrical, and still they can be refined, and this can bulge this way. There's always this logic, you know, when you have cloth here, it needs to go somewhere, you can't just kill it. The thicker the material is, the less it will die quick. So if you have silk, you will get those fine wrinkles that they all of a sudden die. But if you have, this is obviously not a silky hat, so even those here, they don't make much sense now. I think it needs to be flat. Here I'm talking about, or I'm masking, but we'll look into that. So yeah, I'm keep looking what needs to be changed. And also the sharpness of the wrinkles is happening usually where they pinch and then they spread, and it gets this wide volume. I actually do, yes, I do work. I draw still, and sometimes I do clay, but a lot more rare than I want to. To be fair, it's all about prioritizing the time right now, because I have so many unfinished stuff, and now, for example, I'm again working on something that is not, wasn't there, so I need to finish my stuff and not start more even if traditional or not. So you see this one, I don't think it was a great... No, actually it was fine, but it's a bit too... It's coming out a bit too straight, so we can soften this. It's too punchy. Yeah, that's what it gets. Boom. And then you have a spread. And of course, if you have a cloth here, it will go round. Right? You need to be able to... This refinement gives a bit more this realistic feel and more natural of the wrinkle, of the fold. And that's how you have it from Substance, right? From Marvelous, right? Those soft, nice. Folds. If you look from the side, folds go that way. Man, if you have many unfinished projects, don't hang out with me, because I'm the same. No, I wanted to say, if you have many unfinished projects, give them some time, and when you reopen them, it feels very satisfying to look at them with different eyes, because you have grown as an artist. So hopefully you will read them differently. Great. What else? These shoes will be quite fun. I love drawing or doing shoes. So why I have two meshes is because I had this dude with from the Z-spheres, right? From here. Then I started working on this and I duplicated it to try something, just to basically dynamesh the face with the beard. And I worked on the dynameshed, but then I wanted to get back to the ones with the poly groups, so I have to project. But I hate projecting, and I don't think I'm gonna live stream projection. It would be probably the most... Yeah, I think we're gonna qualify super quick for the most boring stream ever. So let's stay away from that. I also wanted to make... I saw one... like, you know how people put... Oof! Hear this out. This is for... Special for Michael. This song. I mean, sometimes it's nice to, you know, when you do your initial fold, just let your your stroke to be a bit more continuous, and only then you can use the move. But don't be afraid that it doesn't go in the very, very right direction, because you can always, it's digital, right? So you can always move it after. But the stroke shows if it was continuous, then it looks a little way better actually. And you need to have this, you know, like there is weight to it, so I think you have to spend the time to make it, like to follow a nice curvature and all that. It can be bumpy. These are again made up, so I might at some point for sure look at some reference. Yeah, the process of the puppy, for sure. I haven't picked the breed yet. It's not gonna be a Dalmatian. I know there were people talking about the Dalmatian, and it makes sense, but we already have one. So you let me know what puppy is he holding, guys. Yeah, thanks guys. Yeah, you're welcome. I mean, all this is, all the streams, they will be, they are usually for Patreons, but since this one started as a holiday fun, I thought just keeping it this way. So regarding the what was it? Oh, sculpting practice for wrinkles. Sculpting practice for wrinkles. I have a... Yeah. Where you start with wrinkles and with folds is get something that inspires you. You like it. Pinterest is your friend. And do a study. But don't copy it. Try to understand why the wrinkle is there. Maybe the first time you do it, you won't understand what I mean. You'll just be satisfied from the result that it looks the same. But this is not enough. What you need to understand is that, for example, let's look at this area, right? So there is a wrinkle that comes from a big volume, so definitely in some extent there will be all these saggy folds that there's a hint that there is a big compression up there, and then there is like this loose cloth. So then you get your wrinkle here, main one, let's say. This is a bit more of a leading one, right? Then I'm explaining the thought process of it. Then again, you will have the compressed wrinkle that needs to run somewhere. This volume can't just die there, it always leaks, you know? Look at this. This is obviously, we're gonna help this one to leak backwards, and because it's pinched there, we're going to kinda have that pinching. without looking something, it's just obvious that this is how it's gonna be. In a way, the volumes, they talk, you know? And then of course you can clean it, you can, because it can be all lumpy and bumpy. You can build a bit if the topology is playing tricks on you. A few times back and forth, it will be working. And then, you know, like maybe here we can let another one even more in, boom, and it dies there, right? Then those are the pans, so let's create in there some. And when you look at this, now this area, starting to have a bit of rhythm, a bit of softer areas and finer areas. Everything is rhythm. Also, don't have them all soft. You need to be concrete with your shapes. So, not to get too far from where I've started, you need to understand why there is a wrinkle here, where, for example, the knee will be, and where the knee is, you might want to just enhance a little bit the shape and give a hint that there is someone underneath. So by observing the logic, you will still need some reference, but do you see this? Do you feel it? It's all a trick of how we make the audience perceive things. So those tricks are visual, and the visual is built on logic. So by understanding the logic, you'll be able to make it look better and be more convincing. If this could be considered as an answer. I'm sorry if it wasn't very useful. When you see that something, for example, I'm still unsure about this, but we will see how it will play. Maybe we'll get rid of it at some point. Don't be afraid of being your own biggest critic. If I doubt my decisions, I think everyone doubts, but I think you need to learn how to go through that doubt, and you need to believe in yourself basically. What I mean by that is, so it doesn't sound so vague, is there's always a moment of doubt that you need to go against and go through, and see yourself, carry yourself to the other side. Because when everything is blank or a sphere or just clay, right, there is this enormous amount of doubt there, just because there's the possibility of, you know, of the unknown, and anything could happen. So stick to your guns, go through the work, and even if you're doubting, convince yourself that you've done it once, twice, and you will do it again. The doubt is a normal, I think, artistic, I wouldn't even say characteristic, but I would say it occurs and it's part of us. Okay, this is getting somewhere. Let's have it with symmetry. Okay, we have hands. So guys, for example, I wanted to say, like, if we didn't have those hands, we will have all these, in a way, fairly okay-ish wrinkles, but nothing more, right? What I mean is, hands and obviously face, but hands, because people do face and then they're like, okay, done. Hands are so expressive that at the moment, the entire back of this is being supported visually by those two gloves, you know? It's like, oh no, there's, it's interesting enough and there is something going on. Obviously there will be the puppy, so it will be become at some point more interesting. But let's try something here. But yeah, what I mean is, hands are giving a lot and they're very expressive, and don't neglect them ever. So wrinkles, where they get thin, they get flat. So here, and then when they get wide, they go broad. Or where they get broad, they get wide. You see this? This was a good example of, I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep it, but the wrinkle itself here, it kind of works, right? So this is purely observation from different wrinkles, different folds, different draperies over the course of time. And now, I don't know, I'm just trying and I'm looking, and if it feels right and if you like it, how it breaks all this side, you keep it. What I'm gonna do, guys, is you let me know if those are fairly enjoyable, because if they are, I think I'll bring my other serious works and I'll try to finish them together. I want to work badly on some of them. So the Minotaur is a big contender at the moment. Kind of feel that. Nudge to do it. If not, that's okay. And I can try finishing them. Hey, Marto. Радвам се те вие, братле, весела Коледа. Няма еволата, ти си цар и ти. Guys, this was Bulgarian, so if you don't know how it sounds, this is how it sounds. So in a way, at some point, I would like to carve a little more the thin legs of this dude in there. It would have been much easier to do quite a bit of, yeah, sorry, I forgot what I was saying. Thanks, Andre, glad you like it, man. You know, and the more you go towards the pressure, like these guys here, the thinner the wrinkles will be, because they are just about to extinct. So, obviously, before extinction, we have those thinner. This was stupid to line them up, so I'll go back. Or actually, I'm just gonna delete it here, smooth it, and we can go in another direction. There we go. Because no one knows, right? It's everything is a lie. So I'm using also, guys, a lot of the smooth with shift, and then you release the shift. What's in there? Oh, this is this. Let's enhance this one a little bit. Because what's the difference is, when you use shift, it's just a simple smooth. You know this, but it's super useful, because it, the other is more of a smooth, but preserves a bit more the shape. So when you like the shape, but you don't like the bumpiness, I would suggest you to use smooth with shift. And then let go shift. 1 hour 50 minutes, 3 o'clock.
Yeah, I think, I mean, for most of the Andre, for most of the cases, for example, here I want, right? Like, let's focus here. Now I want really to smooth here, so I'm holding the shift, and then when I go now, I let the shift go, and I'm going very gently towards the wrinkle, so I can dictate a bit more of how much I want this to remain. It's just, you give yourself time, and once you're happy, you just stop smoothing, you know? And with the clay, of course, at some point, guys, we'll go and we'll really start refining everything. Just because clay on a low intensity is nothing beats it. It's the ultimate control. So, wrinkle, we said. Here towards the side will be stronger, and here in the middle it will get softer. It will still, it can still bulge, but it will be softer. Now I'm doing this with the move and holding Alt, so I can in a way inflate on alpha. Sorry, on the normal. Cool. How are we doing now? This is where we were, and this is where we are. Fancy but fun. Yep. I like doing that sometimes because it kinda, you know, carries me through if I feel like, hey, this is totally, like, whatever, it's not nice, or, you know, just little encouragement for your own sake, it won't hurt. Thank you, Adrian. I am not streaming, actually.
This is a dream. No, I'm kidding. I'm not streaming usually, and I've started super recently. Great, so the next thing is the coat and the dog. Twin Peaks remix. I have no idea. I think it's Moby. Yeah, there we go. Go. Unless the previous was Twin Peaks. Let me see. HBO team confirmation. I think so. Christmas carols. I love them. Okay, where are we? Oh yeah, I wanted to say, you know how people tuck in some pillows and by the way, we need a buckle there. Oof, let me save because I might fail miserably for this buckle. Not that I don't have buckles, but I want to do a pend. What are we gonna do now? Let me see. hold on. So this polycube. Ta-da. We don't need to. But we had two eyes, that's why. Okay, hold on. We're gonna get this and then polycube. Yay. Okay. Gizmo. Gizmo. Nice. Let's get all these guys. Like that, then from the one side we can bevel, this one, that way, and then we make polygroup and we Q-mesh again, and again, and again. Think once again. Oops. Yeah. No. Don't attach it. Great. And now we make it soft and we bring it up. We make it harder and we tilt it and we pull it on the side. Oops. Our mask wasn't solid enough. Great, let's see. Now it's fine. So we do this. Boom. We get everything else. Center. Tweak. Boom. If we press, yep, okay, we have something. How else the buckle looks like? What else? So this is how it's going to look if it's... Yeah, if we subdivide it, let's do a little bit of inflate here. I have a menu and we can do just a little bit. That's better. Ooh. Ah, we can insert maybe an edge. Stick to multi and press once so you can have that. And then we can isolate the polygroup, go from the side, switch off the... There we go. And now you can press mask and you can raise that guy. I pressed mask by feature and I have border and groups. So now we have a very, very quick buckle. Of course, this could be, you know, supported. Let's add a, oops, not many, just a single. We could have even make a hole and drag it out as yeah, maybe it would have been better. as a circular or just split in there, chamfer it, and then boom. But it's okay. No, we don't need 8. It always adds 8. Let's add just one single right there. And let's get that topological brush and move it out. Great. Cool. It will do for now. Maybe we don't need those side edges, by the way. So I would probably just alt and yeah, move them away, and we can bevel that whole thing. Edge loop complete and edge loop that. Now we have this. If you want a bit of support, you can do this, and then you can just tap, tap, tap. Now it looks like this, even better. We set these guys. Insert, alt, to remove, 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 and then let's bevel it. It should remember, but... Oh, it beveled even this, why the fuck not? Boom. Okay, we have yet another buckle. Let's place that in place. I'll duplicate it in case we wanna. By the way, here is the moment where I might have to try the stager. So in geometry, I haven't tried it, by the way. I'm not sure if Michael is still around. I think no, but if he was, I would have asked him. Stager. When pressed, the home stage will restore, will store the transformation values of the selected subtool. This includes the home stage. Let me save once again. And then, yeah, I might look into how we can do this. And in the meantime, I can place it where I want that to be. But yeah, basically, guys, the stager, I think it's amazing because it will... You'll be able to change stuff and then they will update where you have this, which is pretty nice, and it's something that I've always been missing, but I might need to look into it. So real quick, what's happening with this belt? First of all, don't change it when it's high res. If you can reconstruct, then please do. Nice. We might have to redo it, but that's okay. Okay, so this part will go on top, actually, and then we'll have to... This will have to grab it, go back and have a bolt or whatever, and then this guy will come here and it will be with the tip, the ending. Great. And of course, what's happening with belts usually is that they will have this.
but that's in a bit, right? When we... Right now, this is not the build that we want to work on. So I'll do it in a second. Or not, just gonna get a coffee first. Of course, on the sides, you'll have more compression. So the belt might, you know, be a bit more of this. And then you'll have this. And it will make the guy a lot less full. And we will make a... We can append a cube, whatever. And downscale it and put it like this. And make it like that. Basically what I want is... I mean, we can totally sculpt it just straight. But we want to dynamesh it. Cool. A pillow, real quick pillow. Of course you can do it many different ways. But the pillow is so simple that, you know, you don't have to think much. You can change the transform into maybe Y as well. Oops, not Y. Z? Yeah, there we go. And now you can control both sides. Doesn't have to be anything fancy. Is because I wanted to just visually, before I decide where this is going to be, I have an idea, but I don't want to be sculpting it there on like entirely in place. So just helping myself a little bit. That's all I'm doing. There we go. We have something. So right now, I'll grab that pillow. And we can put it somewhere here. I want this guy to have used a pillow. And we'll figure out how to tuck it in, you know. It's a very soft one, so it will bend quite a lot. Like underneath there, maybe. What can we do? We can make this stick out and then have this like that.
there's... Okay, so this will be part of where this will poke through, right? One of these will be actually asymmetrically hanging. Let's do that and then soften it quite a lot. And do this and put it there, put it here. Oops. Raining, what's going on there? You guys went silent. I still haven't figured out how this will be, but freestyle, baby. I hear the dog sniffing around. He wants to get in. There's no point of sculpting this. I'm just... doing it for fun. Cause what else are we doing, right? If we're not having fun. guys, I'll be going. Time for coffee. And Faye, she'll kill me if I keep continuing, so yeah, we'll do another one soon. It's getting somewhere and it's time for coffee, so enjoy your holidays, the rest, take care, and I'll let you know when we're live again, probably on Instagram or here. Subscribe if you don't want to miss it, and again, those will become exclusive right after the break. Have fun. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something very, very something little. And we'll do more of those. See you guys. It's quite addictive, this sculpting. And click the bell button indeed, yes. Don't forget to subscribe, because this way you're helping me and you're helping you not to miss anything. Alright, see you guys.